Breaking tonight, firefighters battling this massive fire at a school for almost 2 hours. We're live with the new information we're learning next on WRAL.
If you've been injured in an accident and you feel the insurance company isn't playing fair, do what tens of thousands have done before. Call Hardison and Cochran for a free case review today.
Hardison and Cochran, here for you. 919 All Fours.
It's time to play America's favorite jackpot game. This is Powerball. Good evening, America. I'm Michelle Isles. Tonight, we've got another life-changing jackpot for you in an estimated amount of $190.6 million. Get your tickets out. We'll start things off tonight with 46. Right after that, America, we have 52. Let's congratulate Robin Zapp and Nikki Wolf of Kentucky, who won $1 million. Your next number up tonight is 9. That's followed by 10. And we're rounded out tonight with 36. Now for your winning Powerball number, good luck everyone. It is 14 and your Power Play multiplier is 2. Let's take another look at those winning numbers. Remember, there are multiple ways to win. We'll see you back here Wednesday night. Good night, everyone.
Firefighters right now are on the scene here in Sanford after an abandoned school building catches on fire. We have the details from the chief.
Some of us are going to wake up to frost in the morning. Which areas are under an advisory and when we climb back up to the 80s?
A high-speed chase across two counties ended in a crash. The charges four people arrested could face, plus the tie to possible crimes in a different state.
Boy, smoke could be seen for miles as heavy fire engulfed an abandoned elementary school tonight. Thank you for joining us. I'm Deborah Moore.
Chris Lovinggood. This all happened around 7 o'clock tonight at the old Jonesboro Elementary School in Sanford. WRAL's Julian Grace is in Sanford following this breaking news. Julian, you've been out there for a few hours now. What have you learned?
Well, Chris, what I can tell you, the threat of that fire is now over. But now the investigation on what started it has now started.
In this viewer video, you can see the flames shooting through the building as smoke filled the air. And over the phone, one viewer described the scene.
I was on my way back home from dinner, and just this huge, you know, black pile of smoke was just emulating from behind the dealerships right there.
Firefighters were dispatched to the old abandoned school just after 7 p.m. tonight. And then around 8:40, firefighters had the fire under control.
It was definitely a pretty big fire, something you don't usually see around here, at least.
So far, no injuries to report, but now the investigation starts. And Chief Matt Arnold says a large part of the investigation will have to start in the morning. Here's why.
With the ground being as wet as it is, getting apparatus into and out of places is a little bit of a challenge for us. We're going to have to tear the building apart a little bit. The roof was a metal roof. Collapsed into the building on us. So in order to get into the building and kind of sort through some things and see where it started, we got to get that roof out of the way.
Coming back out here live, that was Chief Arnold that you heard right there. One other point, Chris, that Chief Arnold made earlier tonight, he says the district currently uses this building for storage. Once again, the investigation is still underway, and it could take weeks before we know exactly what happened here.
Yeah, big question is how that fire got started. Julian Grace, live in Sanford. Thank you, Julian.
I'm Mark Boyle in the WRAL Live Center. New right now at 11 o'clock. Following some breaking news, two crashes closing down both directions of I-540, all but about one lane getting by. Here's where this is happening, 540 near Glenwood. And this is a photograph from the DOT website. You can see one crash right here. It looks like one lane on the shoulder may be getting by. And then on the other side, just a few feet away, there's another crash scene. So all of these causing a major issue for those folks who are on the roads. Also looks like there may be a vehicle there possibly spun out in the center of 540. We do have Eric Miller on the way to the scene. He should be there in about 15 minutes or so to give us a better idea and live pictures from the scene. This also gives you an idea of how close those two crashes are. Two red icons indicating that situation that's unfolding right now. So stand by for updates as we're getting more information on how many vehicles involved and if there are any injuries. In terms of the road reopening, the DOT website said it could be close to 2 a.m. So quite a long night ahead for those folks out there.
Yeah, still a lot of traffic out there, too, even at this late hour.
That's right.
Thanks,
yeah.
Mark. Well, maybe April, not quite igloo weather, but temperatures will feel a little bit more like February. Meteorologist Kat Campbell joins us now. And, Kat, people will need jackets in the morning for sure.
You'll be glad that you've got the jacket with you. Everyone likely to wake up to temperatures in the 30s again tomorrow morning. Because of that, everyone's under a frost advisory from 2 a.m. to 9 a.m. And most of North Carolina included in this frost advisory overnight. The concern is that there could be frost that develops, so leave some extra time for your windshield to defrost, and also make sure that you are protecting your pets and your plants. Check out the lows, 37 in Raleigh and Fayetteville, 36 in Durham. We could fall to 33 degrees in Roxboro and South Hill, 34 in Rocky Mount. When you see numbers like this, you'll want the jackets in the morning. But make sure you're dressing in layers. It'll be a chilly start at the bus stop, bright blue skies at least, but by the time the kids are heading home on the school bus, 72 degrees during the afternoon. So you can lose the jackets later in the day. I'll have a closer look at when highs climb back into the 80s coming up.
All right, Kat, thank you.
And to check the real-time temperature before you leave the house, be sure to watch our morning newscast starting at 4:30 a.m. A fifth person has died after today's shooting at a bank in downtown Louisville. The city's police department identified the latest victim as 57-year-old Dina Eckert. Now, four other people died during the shooting at Old National Bank, and eight other people were hurt, including three Louisville police officers. Investigators also say the gunman died.
A multi-county high-speed chase ended in a crash this afternoon in Wayne County.
We're talking four people now in custody as troopers investigate possible ties to crimes in New York. Here's WRAL's Eric Miller.
This chase came to a screeching halt right here, the shoulder of US 70 just west of Goldsboro. The suspect's car leaving tracks in the mud and questions for the troopers now investigating.
It started as a speeding call around 2 p.m. State Highway Patrol saying a car blew past a trooper in Sampson County, then refused to stop. The chase then winding into nearby Wayne County, where the suspect sideswiped one car before being hit by another at the intersection of US 70 and Miller's Chapel Road. The suspect's car then coming to a stop right in front of this Clayton Homes dealership.
Jump and run. And currently think they're inside of a house.
Employees at two nearby businesses confirm the four suspects ran inside this Clayton Homes office. An employee there saying the suspects hid in the back of the building before troopers arrived and arrested them. These eyewitness photos snapped outside show multiple people in handcuffs.
I believe they said they got four in custody.
SHP says they're trying to confirm the names and ages of the four arrested, though several are likely under 18. Investigators also working to determine if the car they were in was stolen and if there's a tie to crimes out of state, including in New York.
State Highway Patrol confirms these four will be facing, at a minimum, felony eluding, among other charges. We'll continue following this case and bring you updates as soon as we get them. In Wayne County, Eric Miller, WRAL News.
Police have identified the victim shot several times near a Rocky Mount Park on Easter Sunday. Officers say 27-year-old Sharif Saunders is in critical condition at the hospital. He was found with gunshot wounds last night on Wellington Drive near Farmington Park. Police have not released any information on a suspect or motive in this case.
An expelled lawmaker was appointed back to the Tennessee House. Nashville's Metro Council voted to reappoint Justin Jones in a meeting earlier tonight. Moments later, Jones marched to the Capitol several blocks away, and he took the oath of office on the steps and entered the building while supporters sang "This Little Light of Mine." Jones and Justin Pearson, who are both black, were removed from the state house chambers following the school shooting in Nashville last month, and they protested.
I think, I hope, I believe, and I pray that today marks a step toward real democracy in the state. I hope that we send a clear message to my colleagues or my former or soon-to-be colleagues in the legislature that we will not allow these attacks on our democracy to happen in the corporate silence. That we will rise up and you try to bury us.
Now, both lawmakers were protesting in support of gun laws, and a third Democrat who took part, who is white, was not expelled. Pearson, who represents Memphis, will have his reappointment considered Wednesday. And while both may be reinstated, the Kentucky governor will still have to schedule a special election for those representative seats. Both have said they do plan to run for reelection.
Tonight in Chapel Hill, city leaders discussed options for increasing the variety of housing. Residents listened to a discussion about the possibility of bringing more missing middle housing to Chapel Hill. It's a move that would create more duplexes and townhouses in a bid to better accommodate the growing population. Many are concerned with losing the character of older neighborhoods. No action was taken at tonight's meeting. Go for a hike, lose your stuff. Cumberland County Sheriff's deputies released photos they hope will help solve a rash of recent car break-ins at a local park. Plus, the Wolfpack Nation is beaming tonight. An alum earns a huge position with the National Hurricane Center. His new duties just ahead. And as we head into the break, here is another look at your winning Powerball numbers. 46, 52, 9, 10, 36. The Powerball is 14. Your multiplier is 2. Tonight's jackpot is worth an estimated $190.6 million. Now, here's Jimmy Fallon.
Hey, everybody, Hannah Waddingham is here tonight. Plus, we have Jenna Ortega, music from Twice, and something to start with the cast of Super Mario Brothers movie tonight.
Mornings are busy. Don't worry, we have you covered.
That water main break.
About 5 degrees cooler. With new up-to-the-minute information you and your family need to start your day.
Your commute will likely be easier this morning.
Getting you prepared for the day every day.
We are only seeing a handful of delays.
Your time is important, so we don't waste it.
WRAL breaking news tracker in Raleigh.
All local, all morning, all for you. WRAL Morning News, coverage you can count on.
Let me introduce you to the ultimate window. Do you feel safer with this or this?
Save 35% off factory direct windows and doors. Call today.
Hey, let's put to Kung Pao.
I'm stockpiling lucky numbers, get more pick three and pick four wins.
You should just play Fireball. When you add it to pick three or pick four, you get an extra draw number for more combinations to match and win.
Oh.
Serving size one cookie.
I think that one's a typo.
Make your own luck with Fireball, the hot new add-on with more combinations to match and win.
Everyone could use a little help with their bills, especially these days. At Duke Energy, we're offering easy ways to help keep your energy bills more manageable. With programs that allow you to pay the same amount each month or pay in installments over several months. Plus, special financial assistance from the Share the Light Fund for those facing hardships. We're Duke Energy, and we're here to help you.
Hey, Mom, can I stay for dinner?
Come on in.
You always say the more the merrier. Your heart is just as big as their stomach. Your family always comes first. And with so many ways to save at Food Lion,
can we keep him?
You can keep being you. You're always there for them, and we're always here for you. Food Lion, here for every moment.
It just keeps getting worse.
Well, that was too close.
It really ruined everything.
This was it?
I understand. The effects of water can be surprising. Mold feeding on moisture in your crawl space, flooded basements, uneven concrete, and shifting foundations. But it's okay. We got it.
Oh.
At Tar Heel Basement Systems, we'll do a complete home inspection for free, so you can put water back in its place. Schedule a free home inspection today.
New South makes the ultimate window. Built for maximum hurricane protection, energy savings, and to keep your family safe. Don't even think about buying windows from anyone else till you see what our factory can do for you.
Live from WRAL News Headquarters in Raleigh, your number one source for local news. WRAL News, coverage you can count on.
New tonight, deputies with the Cumberland County Sheriff's Office are asking for your help. Deputies believe these photos show who is responsible for multiple car break-ins. We'll make the photos a little bigger for you to see. Officers say the suspects arrived in the black Hyundai Elantra shown here and broke into several cars at Carver's Creek State Park. Anyone with information, you're encouraged to call the sheriff's office.
Tonight, we're working to learn more about two shootings, both on Easter Sunday in Durham. The WRAL Breaking News Tracker captured this video of police putting up crime tape around Ridgeway Avenue last night. Officers did not say why someone fired into a vehicle. Other drivers reported their cars were targeted by gunfire. At least one person was taken to the hospital. Now, earlier, officers responded to another shooting on Massey Avenue. Police say one person was shot and taken to the hospital. That person is expected to survive.
A popular Chapel Hill restaurant is up for sale. Mama Dips has been on West Rosemary Street since 1976. The small house that served up home-style cooking for decades is now on the market for $3.5 million. Mildred Council, better known as Mama Dip, died in 2018, and her daughters run the restaurant now, but they're all at retirement age. They say the business is changing because of the pandemic and staffing shortages, so now they're looking for a new spot to reopen as a counter service restaurant with the same classic recipes.
So even though it's still it's emotional, it's kind of hard to think about not being here. I know this is going to be the best thing for our family.
The family plans to finalize details on the new restaurant by October.
Negotiations this week could determine whether shows at the Durham Performing Arts Center and other theater venues will be put on hold. Before yesterday's matinee of Les Mis at DPAC, actors handed out flyers explaining that performers are prepared to strike. It would be the first strike by the Actors Equity Association of Broadway touring shows since 1968. Actors are raising these concerns: high cost of housing, low per diems, and coverage issues for actors and stage managers while on the road. Talks between the union and producers resume tomorrow.
Driving an electric vehicle could become more expensive soon if lawmakers in our state have their way. A bill in the state Senate would increase the annual user fee for electric vehicles, and it would create a new annual fee for hybrid vehicles of about $90. Lawmakers say those drivers pay little or no gas tax, which is how the state raises money to pay for roads. It's part of a bipartisan package of fees aimed at securing transportation funding. And today, Governor Cooper tweeted a response to State Representative Trisha Cotham's switch from Democrat to Republican. He wrote, quote, "If she keeps her word on the issues, her votes and the positions she takes in the Republican caucus can still stop bad legislation that hurts people she promised to help, regardless of her party," end quote. Cotham left the Democratic Party last week, giving the GOP a supermajority in the House. Republicans now have veto-proof power in both chambers.
Today, Democratic lawmakers introduced legislation to protect access to the abortion pill. However, it is expected to fail in the Republican-controlled House. The political fight follows a ruling from a federal judge in Texas invalidating the FDA's approval of mifepristone. The pill is still available for now. The judge put his ruling on hold for 1 week while the Biden administration appeals the ruling.
For the second time this year, stamp prices might go up. The United States Postal Service announced it is seeking approval to hike the price to 66 cents from 63 cents. Earlier this year, USPS won an approval to hike the stamp prices to 63 cents from 60 cents. USPS says the increase is needed to offset the rise in inflation, and if approved, that new price, that would take effect July 9th. Folks, the clock is ticking to file your taxes. You have just 8 days left to get them done. Don't say we didn't remind you. For most Americans, the deadline to file federal tax returns is April 18th. Here's the deal. You can ask for a six-month extension if you need more time. Data from the IRS shows it's processing returns and sending out payments faster than last year.
Well, that's good news. Well, leave yourself some extra time tomorrow morning for your commute if you travel through Fayetteville. Railroad track maintenance is set to start tomorrow and will close part of Country Club Drive in both directions. This is happening near Murchison Road. The closure could last up to 4 days. A detour sign will be in place for drivers. Once that work is complete, CSX says tracks that cross Shaw Mill Road will be next. That maintenance work is set to last about 4 days sometime next week. Well, hurricane season starts June 1st, and the National Hurricane Center will have a new director with ties to NC State. NOAA named Mike Brennan as the new director based in Miami. He had been branch chief since 2018 and spent 2022 as the center's acting deputy director. During those last 5 years, 18 hurricanes hit the United States, 8 of them major. Brennan earned his bachelor's, master's, and doctorate at NC State University.
Now, look real real closely. You see Kat's face. Yeah. She's very happy because she's also an NC State alum. And also, Mike Brennan was a WRAL weather intern right here.
And so was Kat.
What?
Look at that.
I don't know the talent.
She's cheesing right now. Look at her.
Well, we're very proud of him, all the NC State grads. But it's going to be so great, you know, in times that really count, to have somebody local running the National Hurricane Center. So I think that's a really big deal, and we're certainly really proud of him. So congratulations. Here locally, no hurricanes to talk about for now. Our fitness forecast tomorrow morning, a chilly start. If you can hold off on getting your exercise until, say, 10 a.m., you'll be out of the 30s and into the 50s. By noon, we're up to 66. And during the afternoon, 72 degrees, full sunshine. It is going to be a beautiful day if the kids maybe want to go for a bike ride after school. Get some fresh air while you can this week. We have 3 days in a row that will be perfect afternoons to be outside. 72 tomorrow, 79 degrees on Wednesday, 83 on Thursday. Thursday, not very humid. Dew points in the 50s should make for a comfortable day. So all 3 days really look great. And we need some sunshine and dry weather to dry out this week after all the rain we saw over the weekend. The next chance for rain will come on Friday. And based on the new models that I've seen tonight, we're probably going to need to bump up rain chances during the day on Friday. So check in for that update on WRAL News tomorrow morning, starting at 4:30 with Elizabeth Gardner. Saturday, a smaller chance for rain at just 20%. The next system that we're watching is an interesting one. An area of low pressure is likely to spin up in the Gulf of Mexico toward the middle of the week. Not entirely out of the question that this could develop into something subtropical. That means it wouldn't have full tropical characteristics. That's not the most likely scenario, but we will watch that very closely. If it is strong enough and organized enough, it could get a name, a subtropical storm name. That hasn't happened in April since 2017. But still, as I mentioned before, it's not likely and it wouldn't change the impact. We're going to watch for this system to head to the northeast and potentially bring some rain our way on Friday. In the meantime, we've got a little time for the rivers to slowly die down. The Neuse River at Smithfield expected to fall below flood stage tomorrow, but the Tar River in Tarboro likely to be in minor flood stage tomorrow through Friday this week. Luckily, it's minor flood stage for both of those rivers. The next 3 days looking really nice. Tonight, we've got the frost advisory, but after tonight, low temperatures are going to be out of the 30s. Once we get to Thursday, that starts a stretch of 4 days in a row with high temperatures in the 80s. Our best rain chances come Friday and Sunday this week.
All right, thanks, Kat.
Well, the first ever top 20 matchup on the diamond in Buies Creek. That's coming up, plus Ron Brindamore's thoughts on tonight's Hurricanes game.
It's trash, to be honest with you.
Ouch. Coming up in sports, Casey Hintz has highlights of some of the lowlights and more reaction.
Good evening, I'm Gail Hurd. Welcome to tonight's drawings for Monday, April 10, 2023. Well, let's get started tonight with our Carolina pick three. Here we go. Our first winning number is a 6. Our second number is 9. Our third number is 6. And our, eight. And our pick three fireball number is 4. Joining me for tonight's drawing is our auditor from Thomas & Gibbs. Now let's move to the Carolina pick four. Good luck, everyone. Is that first winning pick four number? All right, it's a 3. Our second number is 2. Third number tonight, 1. And our fourth number, here it comes. It's a 5, and our pick four fireball number is a 6. We're turning now to the Carolina Cash 5, and no one wins the top prize tonight. Tomorrow's top prize is estimated at $120,000. Good luck, everyone. Here's that first winning Cash 5 number. It's a 7, and our second number is 22. Third number tonight is a 5. Our fourth number is 1, and the final number in our Cash 5 this evening is 23. The North Carolina Education Lottery has contributed over $9 billion to education. Get your winning numbers right here every night on your exclusive station for the North Carolina Education Lottery.
The current time and temperature brought to you by Honda dealers of the Carolinas.
Identical twins Bethany and Stephanie both struggled with CPAP for their sleep apnea. But Stephanie got Inspire, an implanted device that works inside the body. There's no reason to keep struggling.
Inspire. Learn more and view important safety information at inspiresleep.com.
Wow, this is strong.
Pace yourself. I see new winners overdo it on the coffee all the time. And with these new scratch-offs out right now, well, You'll see.
Hey, gals. My name's Steph. I'm the new winner here. What are your names? Have you had the coffee? I'd never had espresso before, but it's not bad, right? And how about these jackets? I'm really loving the gold. Anyway, it was so nice meeting you, but I have to go get a massage because I think I need to relax.
Told you.
New scratch-offs mean new winners. This month's tickets pack $60 million in total prizes.
When you get Spectrum One, you get fast, reliable internet for $49.99. Then, surprise, you find out you're also getting free advanced Wi-Fi with Security Shield. Another surprise, you're also getting a free line of unlimited mobile with 5G. Surprise, it's me. With Spectrum One, you're going to be very surprised by all the free stuff you get. Or you would be if I hadn't already just told you. Still, when you get in there, could you act surprised? Well, something for the people in the store.
Spectrum One. Internet, advanced Wi-Fi, and unlimited mobile. All for just $49.99. Call, click, or visit a Spectrum store today.
I struggled with CPAP every night. But now that I got the Inspire implant, it's making me think of doing other things I've been putting off.
Like removing the tattoo of your first wife's name.
Inspire. Learn more and view important safety information at inspiresleep.com.
WRAL Sports starts now. Sponsored by Easter Automotive.
I say this with love, Caniacs. Everyone should just take a breath and relax.
Okay, I still very much believe that, but this team, they work too hard. They're too talented. Yes, still without Svechnikov, but boy, the Carolina Hurricanes are definitely in a funk, and it showed tonight. Canes, quicksand from puck drop. Up in Ottawa. Let's get you up north. I remind you, this was a game in hand night. Playing with some, I don't know, urgency would have been nice, but instead the Canes down 2-0 early. Late second period, Brett Pesce finally breaks through. First goal in 37 games. Canes crawling back into it. Third period, Carolina on the man advantage. Brent Burns puts his entire body into this one. 15th of the season. That's 55 goals by the blue line, and boy, we had a brand new game. Later, Canes back on the power play. Stefan Nason called for goaltender interference. And the Oscar goes to, that's an atrocious call. Goalie sold it, but we are still skating 4-on-4 and sends Cap alive. That's the game winner. We've got a very direct and hoarse Roddy B in the postgame.
You know, I had to juggle the lines, I had to change the power play in midterm because we had guys out there that are doing nothing. I mean, if we're just being honest, you know, and that's, I mean, we're going to have to call it the way it is. And, you know, some of these guys that we count on have to start, you know, being threats when they're out there.
Boy, big night tonight at Jim Perry Stadium. Number 14 Campbell hosting its first ever top 20 showdown with number 17 Coastal Carolina in town for a pair of midweek games. Now, we won't talk about why this was scheduled on a Monday. I digress there. The Shots, they're the number 2 team in mid-major rankings. Your Camels, number 1. Let's get you down to Buies Creek. Just as they have 18 other times this season, the Camels striking gold in the first. Already up 1-0. Bases juice for Lawson Harrell. Right back up the middle. He finds a sweet spot. A bases clearing two-bagger. And it's 4-0. Campbell. Very next inning, Bryce Arnold. That's a frozen rope if I've ever seen one. His 13th, a long ball of the season. That also puts him in a cluster. 13th in the nation in home runs. It was 5-0 Camels. How about closer, Ty Cummings, making his first career start. He goes 5 hitless innings. Shots put up a 4 spot in the 7th, but it's not enough. Third-ranked win for Campbell. 9-4 the final. The two meet again tomorrow afternoon. Duke captain Jeremy Roach is setting out to test the NBA waters, but the junior guard is leaving the door open to return to Durham by maintaining his college eligibility. He has until May 31st to withdraw. That now makes it 3 Blue Devils who have declared for the draft. 5 had made plans, so then there was 1. Speaking of, let's check in on Kyle Filipowski. Ah, yes. Flip continues to just tease Blue Devil Nation, keeping them on pins and needles. Shortly after Roach's announcement, Filipowski tweeted, "Darn, I missed the window again. Guess we gotta wait till tomorrow." We'll see what Flip tweets tomorrow.
Right? It has to mean
it's gotta mean that, right?
Yeah. He's staying.
Right. Yeah. Also, really quickly, Kane's back in action tomorrow. That is the most direct I've seen Roddy in a long time. Ooh. So hopefully that lights a fire under them tomorrow night.
Fingers crossed.
Lost his voice. Oof.
Thanks, Casey.
Well, as we head to break, a live look at 2 serious crashes on I-540. Traffic is backed up for miles, both east and westbound. A live report from the WRAL Breaking News Tracker up next.
Why is there so much space? Are we getting a dragon?
The Volkswagen Atlas, with more cargo volume than the Honda Pilot. Visit your local Volkswagen dealer for 4.9% APR financing for 72 months on a new 2023 Atlas or Atlas Cross Sport.
Good people are trustworthy.
good people go out of their way to do what's best for you. Whether they're friends or complete strangers. At UNC Health, you'll find good people around every corner.
I had a lot of bad days with gout, but that one took the wedding cake. Even with medicine, my uric acid was still too high to stop painful gout buildup. Then a gout specialist told me about Krystexxa.
Krystexxa is a prescription medicine for adults with gout whose symptoms are not controlled by other gout medicines.
I learned Krystexxa quickly starts working to break down gout buildup.
Krystexxa is an infused medicine. Serious, life-threatening allergic reactions can occur while taking Krystexxa. Tell your doctor right away if you have symptoms such as shortness of breath, trouble breathing, dizziness, itching, or swelling of the throat or tongue. Krystexxa is not recommended if you have high levels of uric acid without a history of gout. Do not take Krystexxa if you have a rare disorder called G6PD deficiency or favism. Before receiving Krystexxa, tell your doctor if you have a history of heart problems and all the medicines you take. Krystexxa may cause gout flare-ups, allergic reactions, nausea, bruising, sore throat, constipation, chest pain, and vomiting.
I received Krystexxa for about 6 months. Now I'm in control, not gout.
Find a doctor who specializes in gout at goutdocnow.com.
No matter where you are, from the Blue Ridge to the beach, Capital Chevy, your number one Chevy dealer, still has you covered. Get used to sky-high expectations and standards and a smooth buying experience each and every time. Backed by our wide inventory and dedicated service team, here to help you with whatever you need, wherever you are. Thanks for helping us win the Chevrolet Dealer of the Year and shop the number one dealer in the Carolinas for the second year in a row. The best deals are always at Capital. Find new roads at CapitalChevrolet.com.
Get 3.44% APR for 36 months plus 500 purchase allowance on a 2023 Cadillac XT4, XT5, and XT6. Visit your local Cadillac dealer today.
Hit the ground running in the most adventurous Honda vehicles yet. Like the Pilot and Passport Trail Sport. Or the Ridgeline, made more rugged with better off-road performance. And more capable with different driving modes available to conquer snow, mud, and sand. Adventure on in the Honda for you. Buy online, reserve from select dealers, or visit your local Honda dealer today.
Let me help you with that.
I'm good, man. Thanks.
Are you sure?
Everyone can use a little help. Volkswagen Tiguan with Front Assist. Visit your Volkswagen dealer today and lease the 2023 Tiguan S for just $249 a month.
A local sheriff's office running on overtime pay. Thursday at 6 on WRAL.
We continue to follow breaking news right now. Two crashes on I-540 tonight causing major backups.
That's why we have WRAL's Eric Miller and the breaking news tracker live at that scene near the Glenwood Avenue exit. Eric, a Raleigh Police Department patrol car was involved, we're learning.
That's right, Chris, but thankfully no Raleigh police officers were injured tonight. Still, this is a massive and sprawling scene. You look behind me. First responders spread over nearly half a mile of I-540 near Glenwood. We know this all started right around 10:30 this evening or a little bit before. We pan over to the right side. There are two cars here down in between the eastbound and westbound lanes. We know one of those cars was traveling eastbound. It hit the guardrail in the center, sent debris into the westbound lanes. That driver had to be rushed to the hospital with serious injuries. While police were responding to that crash, that's when we got this second accident. One of those other cars also, again, in the middle of the two lanes. We don't know which one it is, but one of those cars slammed into the back of an unoccupied Raleigh police cruiser and then careened into the median. We do not know, again, which of those two cars it is, but that driver was taken to the hospital with very serious injuries tonight. Now, we do have at least three lanes of I-540 shut down here this evening as police continue to clean up the scene, as they continue to investigate what happened. Looking at that RPD cruiser there, you can see the damage to the back end, so incredibly serious, and the backups here likely to last for several hours as first responders continue to their work. Obviously, a developing story. We'll continue to follow it throughout the night. It'll bring you updates in the morning. Back to you.
All right. Thank you, Eric. And certainly think how worse it could have been if those police officers were in their vehicle. All right. So if you stumble across an armadillo in North Carolina, state wildlife leaders want to know about it.
Yeah. The NC Wildlife Resources Commission asks if you see a nine-banded armadillo, don't touch it. But if you see one like this on your screen, upload a picture and report it on the iNaturalist app. It's part of the state's efforts to track the animals as they expand north. The app is free to download, but you can also email the photo to NC Wildlife.
And like she said, don't touch it.
Don't touch it.
All right, thanks for joining us tonight. And make sure to join us for our morning newscast starting at 4:30 a.m.
The Tonight Show with Jimmy Fallon is up next, and tonight's guests include Jenna Ortega. Have a good night.